webinar, an introduction to archery and rifle shooting, which will be taken by Mr. Anup Agrawal. Talking about Mr. Anup Agrawal, he is one of the senior expert in Bhavan's Nature and Adventure Center. So Anup sir, up to you.
Okay, thank you so much Yogi sir for the introduction. As Yogi sir said, I am working with this organization from past 7 years, and I have learned many things, and from those I am going to, you know, share my knowledge and my experience about archery and rifle shooting. So we'll start with the archery first.
Okay, so what is archery? Archery is an art, sport, practice or a skill of using a bow to shoot arrows. The word comes from the Latin arcus, meaning bow or an arc. Historically, archery was used for hunting and combat. You might have seen in movies and, you know, different stories how archery means the bow and arrow were used to kill the enemies or, you know, for hunting and everything. In modern times, it is mainly a competitive sports and recreational activity. Next slide, please. Okay, so who was Archana? Whenever we used to practice archery, there's always one person that always comes in our mind, that is Arjun. Arjuna was like the other students. What set him apart was his willpower. Distraction are always going to be there in form or another. It will take power to not to get indulged. Determination and strong willpower is the key. So in life you will face many obstacles and many problems, and if you have that determination and willpower, you can achieve all the goals you want and nothing can stop you. Combine the concentration with determination and willpower and be your own Arjuna. Next slide, please.
Okay, so moving on to types of archery. So as we practice archery, there are different types of archery that is practiced throughout the world, and some of them are bow hunting, target archery, field archery, 3D archery, flight archery, clout archery and traditional archery. So we'll start with the bow hunting. Next slide, please. Bow hunting is just like regular hunting but with a bow instead of a rifle. Bow hunters often find a spot in the woods, set up a camp and wait for prey to walk into sight. Jaisa dekh sakte image mein bhi, jaise wo aadmi, the human being or the archer, is how he is trying to hide in the spot. वो कैसे कैमोफ्लेज होके छुप के बैठा ताकि कोई भी प्रे एनिमल, कोई भी जिसे वो हंट कर रहा है, वो कोई उसे देख ना पाए. इट टेक्स अ ग्रेट पेशेंस, रेसिस्टेंस एंड एबिलिटी टू मेंटेन साइलेंट. इसमें आपको बहुत ध्यान से, बहुत आराम से, ना ही कहीं ज्यादा सा भी मूव करना है. अगर मूव करोगे तो आपका प्रे भाग जाएगा और वो आप कर नहीं पाओगे. टिपिकली बो हंटर्स विल यूज आइदर अ कंपाउंड बो और अ रिकर्व बो. सो देयर आर मोर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ बो, कंपाउंड एंड रिकर्व. विल स्टडी अबाउट इट इन द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. Moving on to the target archery. So target archery is a fun and beginner friendly style of archery. This type of archery involves putting a number of targets. तो इसमें होता क्या है, ग्राउंड पे, फील्ड पे बहुत सारे different different targets होंगे. Each one is in different shot away and you have to practice shooting at them. Target archery is not just for beginners. However, this style of archery is performed in Olympics. जैसे ये सिर्फ बिगिनर्स के लिए भी नहीं है, बट ये दिस टाइप ऑफ आर्चरी है ना, ओलंपिक्स में भी प्रैक्टिस किया जाता है. मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज. ओके, तो द नेक्स्ट वन इज फील्ड आर्चरी. फील्ड आर्चरी इज प्रैक्टिस्ड वेयर इंस्टेड ऑफ सेटिंग अ टारगेट इन एन एम्प्टी फील्ड, द टारगेट्स आर सेट अप अक्रॉस अ पोस ऑफ इन अ वुड. तो एज यू कैन टेक इट एग्जांपल इन जंगल, सो देयर वोंट बी अ फिक्स्ड टारगेट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. इट कैन बी एनीवेयर अप द हिल, डाउन द हिल, बिहाइंड एनी ऑब्स्टिकल्स. सो यू हैव टू वॉक द कोर्स एंड यू हैव टू, यू नो, फाइंड द टारगेट्स एंड यू हैव टू शूट एट देम. पार्टिसिपेंट्स हैव टू वॉक अलोंग द कोर्स शूटिंग द टारगेट्स अलोंग द वे. दिस टाइप ऑफ आर्चरी इज मोर चैलेंजिंग देन टारगेट आर्चरी बिकॉज द टारगेट्स हैव, दे कैन बी एनीवेयर अप द हिल, डाउन द हिल, बिहाइंड द ऑब्स्टिकल और एट एन एंगल. Next one is clout archery. So even this type of archery, you know, we have seen in movies and other stories and everything. So the goal in this type of archery is that you have to practice arching your arrow as you shoot in order to hit the target. In clout archery, the bullseye is laid flat against the ground. It won't be, you know, straight in front of you. It will be in the ground, laying flat. So you have to shoot the arrow up and it will, you have to practice so that the arrow will turn downwards and hit the ground. So it requires lots and lots of practice and patience. The next one is flight archery. The goal in flight archery is set your target as far as you can and still try to hit it. This type of archery helps to improving overall skill. So in this archery, आपको हमेशा आपका skills practice करता रहना पड़ेगा. Like you know, patience. You have to practice again and again and again, then only you can hit the target nicely. Moving on to the next slide. Okay, so the very traditional archery. Traditional archery is one of the most popular type of archery. This is performed with traditional bow and without the aid of modern technology. So what are the modern technologies? Even that we'll learn about in the next coming slide. So in this, in the traditional archery is all about getting into the basics. So in this, all you have to do, you have to learn it yourself, how you have to hold the bow, how much you have to pull the string, when to aim, how to aim. So it's all about basics. It's just you, your bow and your target. In traditional bow, there is a lack of stabilizer and other assistance. You are your own stabilizer. So next slide. So as we learned about different type of archery that is practiced around the world, there are also different type of bows, and each bow is used in different type of archery depending on the requirement. So starting with recurve bow and compound bow, crossbow, and the last one is longbow. We'll start with the recurve bow. So what is recurve bow? So there are two types of recurve bow, the modern recurve and the traditional recurve. So in this, the range of the recurve bow is about 45 meters. The traditional recurve bow are made from single piece of wood, and the modern recurve bow is the same shape. However, the limbs of the bow are detachable, thus it can be packed away for ease. As you can see in the picture, those are the bolts. So you can open the bolts, detach the limb, fold it, pack it, and you can take it anywhere you want. Often they are called as takedown bows. The riser on the recurve bow, on which the arrow sets and the limbs are attached, is often made from some such metal, carbon fiber or aluminium. So on which the arrow sets, those are made from carbon fiber or aluminium. There are some good points and the bad points of using a recurve bow. The problems of the recurve bow are, it is easy to maintain, it is very simple to use, there is nothing complicated in this, easy to shoot, require little adjustment. And the cons for the recurve bow are, it requires more skills for accurate shot, you need to practice it, and less powerful than compound bow. So we'll move on to the compound bow. Okay, as you can see in the picture, how complicated or how good this machine looks. You might wonder how this works. So it is more complex in their design. It is more accurate and it has more powerful shots. It uses cams and wheels at the top of each limb and a pulley that connects the two. Each bow hunting, as it means, you can aim at your target or move with the bow fully drawn. It's not like you can pull a string easily and move with your target. If your target is moving, you can move it along. And if you can see in the left hand side, I have labels are there. We'll stop from the top. Bow mounted lever, there is the upper limb. Limb bolts, the bow sight, arrow rest, the grip where you have to hold the bow, stabilizer which helps you, then the limb bolt again, lower limb, arrows, cams, cables, bow strings, locking loop. Okay, this one is where your arrow is going to be locked. Cable guards, peep sight. Peep sight is that when you pull the string, you can, the peep sight helps you to see through it, through the bow sight and to the target. Moving on to the next slide. Okay, before we move to the next slide, there are also some good and the bad points of the compound bow. It is very well constructed. I can see in the picture. Increases force. It gives you more force. It is more accurate. It is light in weight. It is much quiet, more advanced, and less skill is required. And the cons for the compound bow are, increases risk of breaking. If you don't take care of it properly, it is going to break. Harder to maintain, as you need to have some skills, knowledge about how to maintain it, how to repair it. Requirements adjustment, it depends on how you are practicing it. It is more expensive and it is harder to repair. Next slide. Okay, so this one is the crossbow. This kind of crossbow we might have seen in the childhood serials, if I'm not wrong, that was called as Vikraman Betal. So that time we used to wonder what type of it is, a rifle or a bow. So it is a combination of bow and a gun, as it uses a trigger to shoot the arrows and this does not require you to hold the string back. It is locked. Once you pull the string, it is locked. You just need to pull the trigger and it fires. Uses small arrows that are often called bolts. So these are not arrows, these are called as bolts. Crossbows come with both compound and recurve bow. As you can see in the pictures, we'll go again with the labels. We'll go anti-clockwise, starting with the scope. So up one is the scope, you all know what the scope is. Arrow retention spring, that's the barrel, cam, split limbs, limb pocket, foot stirrup. What is foot stirrup? Foot stirrup is basically you can't, you know, just pull the string back with one hand. You need to put your foot on the foot stirrup and you have to pull with both the hands, the string up, and you have to lock it. And that is the use of the foot stirrup. Limb pocket, arrows or the bolts, crossbow quiver, split limbs again, the string, the cables, and the stock is the basically the body. In this also we have some good and bad points. The pros of crossbow arrows: accurate shooting. It is accurate when you shoot it. Knock the bolt and keep it knocked. Safety trigger to prevent misfire. So you know, it has a safety, you know, trigger. If you do, in case if you misfire in it, helps you in that. Very powerful. And the cons for crossbow: it is more expensive. Some laws are on using crossbows. There are some laws. You can openly use a crossbow anywhere. Tend to be louder. Next slide. Okay, so now the longbow, it range up to 180 meters. They are more like traditional recurve bow in that they are one piece of wooden and don't have separate limbs. As you can see in the picture, it is made of one single wood and does not have the separate limbs. The wood they are made of is normally yew or elm, ELM. The modern ones are normally laminated as it helps them to strengthen them and it can last for more longer time. Longbows also have the typically bow look in that they are well known for the D shape, as you can see in the first picture, and they are same as 5 foot archer, and you can see in the second picture the length of the bow is same as the archer. Next slide. Okay, so moving on to arrows. As we saw, there are different type of archeries, different types of bows, and in arrow also there are different types. We'll start with their parts. Okay, the first is arrow spine, the shaft. Okay, arrow spine is the word that describes the stiffness of an arrow. Fletchings, most fletching are plastic veins, but they can be made from feathers also. Compound uses solid veins, and traditional bow uses feather style veins. What is insert? An insert goes in right front end of the arrow and lets you change the arrow tips. There are different types of arrow tips also. It depends on how you use and where you use it. It helps you to change the arrow tips. And arrow tips are pointy business of the arrow. As you can see in the second picture also, the knocking point. You can see clearly how the knocking point is there and you have to knock it there. Next slide. So same as different type of bows and archery, we have different type of arrows also. Starting with carbon arrows. Second one is wooden arrows and third one is aluminium arrows. Carbon arrows are not flexible like some other arrows are. Once they are broken, they are gone. If you once break it, it's gone. You cannot use it again. Okay, so the carbon fiber mein hota kya hai, wo baki flexible nahi hota baki arrows ki tarah. And once you break it, means aap ek baar isko tod doge aur aapse agar wo toot jata hai, to wapas use aap usko nahi kar sakte ho. Jo carbon fibers hote hain, wo jyadatar mehenge hote hain. They are mostly expensive from different arrows. Moving on to the wooden arrows. जो wooden arrows होते हैं, देखा जाए तो बहुत पुराने ज़माने से use किया जा रहे हैं. Most traditionally of choices of is the wooden arrow. In this type of arrows, it is easier to break. Normally have feather fletching. जैसे हमने पहले feathers वाली fletching की बात की थी. अब zoom in करोगे तो वो देख सकते हो wooden arrows के picture में. वहाँ feathers kind of fletchings use किए गए हैं. और उसमें होता क्या है, फ्लेचिंग्स में क्या होता है, देयर आर बेसिकली टू कलर्स. ओके, तो जो ऑड कलर रहेगा वो हमेशा टॉप पे रहेगा. इट इज इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड. एंड मूविंग ऑन टू द एल्युमिनियम एरोस. एल्युमिनियम एरोस आर लाइट वेट एंड हॉलो. वो बहुत हल्के होते हैं और अंदर से खोखले होते, खाली होते हैं. एल्यूमिनियम एरोज कैन बी बेंट एंड बेंट बैक इनटू शेप. तो कभी कभी क्या होता है, वो आप उसको थोड़ा बेंड कर सकते हैं, वापस अपने नॉर्मल शेप पे भी आ सकते हैं. टिपिकली इट इज लेस एक्सपेंसिव देन अदर कार्बन एरोज. तो जो एल्यूमिनियम एरोज होते हैं वो कार्बन एरो से सस्ते होते हैं, थोड़े सॉरी महंगे होते हैं. एक्सपेंसिव टर्म्स एक्सपेंसिव देन कार्बन एरोज. मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट लाइन. ओके, एज वी हैव टॉक्ड अर्लियर देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ एरो पॉइंट्स आल्सो. वी स्टार्ट विद द बुलेट पॉइंट्स. द क्लासिक टाइप ऑफ टिप ऑफन यूज्ड फॉर प्रैक्टिसिंग आर्चरी फील्ड टिप्स. One of the most common types of tips used for small games and target practice. तो ये जो होता है small games और target practice के लिए जाता है, ये वाला tip use किया जाता है. Target points. This basic types are simple, short and cone, जैसा picture में देख सकते हो. And ये ज्यादातर mostly जो होता है वो target practice के लिए ही use है, exclusive for target practice only. Judo points. ये देख सकते हो पॉइंट थोड़ा अलग टाइप का है और वो देखा जाए तो सिग्निफिकेंट बहुत हार्म कर सकता है अगर आप उसको ठीक से मिसयूज करोगे. तो दिस एरो सिग्निफिकेंट कैन कॉज सिग्निफिकेंट हार्म एज द स्प्रिंग लाइक आर्म्स कम्स इनटू प्ले. जो ये टिप्स होता है वो ज्यादातर होता है स्मॉल गेम्स और हंटिंग के लिए यूज किया जाता है. जैसे आप पिक्चर में देख सकते हो और समझ सकते हो किस चीज के लिए यूज किया जा सकता है. ब्लंट टिप्स. They are used when hunting small games or small birds. ये जाता small game जो खेला जाता है या फिर birds hunt करने के लिए किया जाएगा, ये blunt tips. And एक point मैं रखना चाहूंगा, अब कभी भी कोई भी आपके चीज practice करोगे करोगे ध्यान रखो आप, you है ना, आपके कोई भी colleagues or you know anyone, you are standing away from a safe distance. Maintain a safe distance. Concentrate it once you should the arrow generally turn and talk to anyone. You need a proper concern. If you, don't take proper care, you can harm anyone. And please do not harm any birds or animals. Next slide. Okay, so this was all about, different type of archeries, arrows and bows. And the good points and bad points. And I hope you have learned something from the information that I've shared with you about the archery. And now we'll move on to rifle shooting. Rifle shooting is most commonly done using a rifle. The shooting is done at a fixed distance, specific distance from a target. ये जो होता है rifle shooting होता है वो एक fixed distance पे में किया जाता है. जो target रहेगा आपसे fixed distance पे रहेगा और आपको वो rifle use करते हुए target पे hit करना है. Though as you can see in the first picture grooves. If आपने कभी ना rifle के जो barrier रहता है, what I can say as the caliber or the barrel, उसके अंदर कभी आपने ध्यान से देखा होगा तो ये आप grooves दिखाई देंगे. Expiler round, round, round kind of structure. It helps to give power, torque, and it also gives a spin to the projectile around its longitudinal axis during shooting. Okay, and कभी भी आप अगर future में भी कोई भी rifle के अंदर ये देखना चाहोगे तो make sure कोई भी rifle के अंदर कोई भी bullet या pellets नहीं है. Okay, if किसका ध्यान नहीं रहा वो misfire हो सकता है, it can harm you also. So be careful. And if you can observe in the second right hand side picture, I'll give you just 15 seconds or 30 seconds. If anyone can raise the picture that is on the right hand side, and can comment down in the comment box name of the rifle of that. Okay, so whoever is answered that is correct. That is the most famous, one of the famous rifles. That is AK-47, and it is used around the world for, commonly used for war purposes. And you can see the third picture. That is the oldest existing gun in the world. Hale Longjang hand cannon. It was, created in 1288, and it was created in China. The country of origin is China. Okay, it is the oldest existing gun in the world. Next slide. Okay, so as we learned in there are different types of archery and bows and rifles, so there are different type of rifles. We'll start with the bolt action rifle, pump action rifle, lever action rifle, semi-automatic rifle, single shot rifles, and muzzle loading rifles. So we'll start with the bolt action rifles. Okay, so the bolt action rifle. The first bolt action rifles were produced in 1824 by Johann Nicholas. Okay, this firearms are weapon which have a manual operated bolt. Every time you shoot a bullet, you have to load it again manually, and again shoot and again load it. It worked by opening and closing the breech of the barrel with handle that is typically on the side of the rifle, as you can clearly see in the picture. The handle is operated to unlock the bolt, opening the breech and ejecting the spent cartilage. If you have seen in some videos or images, once the bullet is shot, empty shells comes out of a rifle. So it helps to it helps to eject the spent cartilage. Its range is about 800 meters, and the magazine capacity is between 2 to 10 rounds. And you can see in the picture down there, there are labels. We'll start with the barrel, and again we'll get the anti-clockwise barrel, and comes the chamber, ejection port, bolt handle, which we have to, you know, move it straight and back again, safety mechanism, grip, stock, butt recoil pad, that sling stud is where you can, you know, attach a sling and you can carry it in your shoulder also, trigger, then the trigger guard, receiver, magazine floor plate, four stop, and again the sling shot and the muzzle. So we move to the next rifle. The next one is pump action rifle. The first pump action rifle was made by Klotz Patent Firearms in 1884, Samuel Klotz. Okay, and the pump action rifle is a rifle where the forehead can be moved forward and backward in order to eject a spent round of ammunition and to chamber a new one. For example, take it as a shotgun. You know the shotgun is, even that is a pump action. Okay, you have to load it. Okay, the forehead, you have to move it forward, backward, shoot, again load it. And its range is about 41 meters, and the magazine capacity is between 4 to 5 rounds. And it depends on the length of the barrel. We again will go through the labels one. We'll start with the front side. The front side, the barrel, midpoint, bedside, the gate, chamber, and the smoke infusion. Get the information about that from there. The bolt, ejection and ejection port, receiver, safety button. The safety button is important. The stock, the trigger, magazine loading port, where you have to load your magazine, load the bullets. Model, stamp and gauge. You'll get the model number and everything over there. Forehand or the forearm, which we have to move it forward and backwards. Barrel, screw cap, and the muzzle, the choke tube location is there. So we'll move to the next rifle. Okay, so the lever action rifle. The first lever action rifles on the market work same again by Klotz first and second model ring lever. If you can see in the labeled picture what the lever is. Okay, the ring lever rifle was in the shape of a ring. The lever action rifle was used the lever action rifle uses a lever which is located near the trigger guard and can be connected to the trigger guard itself. तो वो दो काम किया जाता है उसका एक रहता है वो लोडिंग भी होता है उससे लोड भी होता है और वो ट्रिगर कार्ड जैसा भी एक काम करता है तो उसका जो फेमस लेवर एक्शन राइफल जो था वो था विंचेस्टर और एक था उसका नाम था हेनरी ये दोनों लेवर एक्शन राइफल्स फेमस है जो अभी भी है और इनकी रेंज है 91 मीटर्स तक द फायर रेंज इज अबाउट 91 मीटर्स मैगजीन कैपेसिटी इज अबाउट 10 राउंड्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन द कैलिबर एंड द बैरल लेंथ नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज आवर फेवरेट kind of rifles we always like that we always you know used to use or in some games also we have used this kind of rifles which is semi-automatic rifles. In 1908 General Manuel Mondragon patented the world's first gas operated semi-automatic rifle Mondragon rifle M1908 and mostly stands for the model number the M and the 1908. The semi-automatic rifle also known as self-loading action arm are designed to be loaded with multiple rounds of center fire ammunition and will fire single round every time the trigger is pulled. So you don't have to load it again and again once you shoot one bullet. Once the magazine is loaded, you can just pull the trigger. Magazine is empty, you can again reload it and use it. You don't have to, you know, load it again and again to shoot each bullet. They use recoil, gas, or blowback. Or blow forward to eject the spent cartilage. Then automatically chambers a new round and reset the fire pin so that the rifle is ready to fire as soon as the trigger is pulled. तो जो भी mostly काम होता है loading का वो जाता है खुद ही automatically हो जाता है rifle से. इसमें हम लोग को इतना बार बार load करने का problem नहीं आता है. We'll again go with the label part. Barrel, the front sight. Ejection port, rear sight, charging handle, forward assist, butt stock, safety button, the pistol grip, trigger, magazine, magazine release. If you want to, you know, remove the magazine, that's the button. Hand guard, vertical foregrip, and the muzzle. Next slide. We'll move to the next slide. Okay, the single shot rifle or the break action. If the volunteers who are working in our organization, Bhavan Mishra Advanced Attack, the typically rifle we use is the single shot rifle. We have to load it every time we shoot a bullet. John Moses Browning had designed this rifle and later on selling the rights to Winchester in the early 1880s. Okay, and the capacity is obviously single shot and ranges up to 1500 meters. Single shot rifle just hold just one center fire cartridge and must be reloaded after every shot. So you shoot a bullet, you have to again load it, shoot it, again load it, shoot it, again load it. These rifles are very simple design and are primarily used today for shooting for competitions and for large hunting games. They are known for their accuracy at long distance. Again, I just told you that the firing is about 1500 meters. So it is a long distance and you can help it. Next slide. Okay, so this type of rifle was a very old type of rifle and we cannot use in, you know, the modern day ammunition. The muzzle loading rifle. So we'll start with the parts. Okay, we'll start with the front side. Then the rear side, scope mount. If you want to mount a scope, you can mount it over there. Breech, trigger safety, recoil pad, stock, often synthetic, ramrod, the pellets and the bullets. Muzzle loading weapons cannot be used in modern days ammunition. The gunpowder is measured out and filled directly into the breech from the gun muzzle. And the projectile is also pushed down the rifle barrel. There are different ways of igniting the charge. The one is black powder, which was, you know, made by the Chinese people in China. And the I'm sorry if I pronounce it wrong. And it can be used, this type of powders can only be used in muzzle loading rifles. So we'll move for the next slide. Okay, so these are the some interesting, you know, the parts that we see in the rifle. Scope, cartridges, rifle sling, if you want to carry it in your shoulder, magazine, bipod, which helps to, you know, keep the rifle steady for shooting. Next. Okay, so these are the some list of weapons, handguns and small arm that is used by our Indian Army. Okay, the AKM rifle, which is an assault rifle, which is a gas operated or rotating bolt. As I have told you what the bolt action rifle is. Okay, AK-103 assault rifles. Next one is T-91 assault rifle. This is mostly used by the special forces. INSAS 1B1 assault rifle. Same again, the second model, INSAS. It's like IMG. Light machine gun. This is mostly used for cover fire in field. And the last one is long range assault rifle, which is gas operated. Next slide, please. Okay, here also are the some list of, you know, military equipment used by Israel, United States, and also by Russian people. We'll start with the Israel one, Jericho 941, which is semi-automatic pistol, Glock 17. Again, semi-automatic pistols, IMIZ, which is submachine gun, suppressed Ruger, which is a semi-automatic rifle, M16A1, assault rifle, Kar-15, again an assault rifle, United States M9, which is a pistol, M11 pistol, BNT APC9 Pro K, which is a submachine gun, MP5 is a submachine gun, M16, which is an assault rifle, MK24 ASR, which is an advanced sniper rifle. And moving on to the Russian small arms, Makarov pistol, P96 pistol, PP2000, which is a submachine gun, SR2 Varex, which is a submachine gun, and Dragunov is a sniper rifle, which is semi-automatic. we'll move on to the next slide. Okay, so the next slide is about pistol. Pistol are type of handgun, which is a short barrel projectile weapon. So pistol were originate in 16th century, earlier when handguns were produced by Europe. And down are the list of different types of, you know, pistols: single shot, multi-barrel, harmonical pistol, revolver, lever action. How the lever action rifle was there. We have also lever action pistol, semi-automatic, same, and machine pistols. Next slide. Okay, the first one is single shot. Second is multi-barreled. As you can see the picture, there are two barrels. Revolver, we all know about the revolver. And the harmonical, which is one of my favorite kind of pistols. As you can see in the picture, you can load the bullets in the magazine, and you have to slide it manually. Once you shot the bullet, you have to again slide it. The lever action pistol, like the lever action rifle, and the semi-automatic pistol. Next slide, please. Okay, a machine gun pistol is self-loading pistol capable of fully automatic or a burst fire. Fully automatic, it will go like da 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 da, or a burst fire, for example, in three shots, that kind of thing. Next slide. Okay, one of our, you know, the favorite guns we always, you know, you read in games or you have seen in many movies, the sniper rifle. A sniper rifle is high precision, long range rifle. Requirements include accuracy, reliability, and mobility. The modern sniper rifles is portable shoulder fire weapon system, which is with a choice between bolt action and a semi-automatic. Bolt action, you have to load it, and semi-automatic, once the magazine is loaded, you don't have to load it every time you shoot a bullet. The telescope sight. The sight most important characteristic that sets a sniper rifle apart from other military and policeman arms, much offers a great magnification than the other, you know, scope using in assault rifle and any other different guns. Next slide. Okay, our most, you know, one of our favorite night vision device, a night vision device NVD, also known as night opticals observation device NOD, and a night with device goggles. The image produced is typically monochrome, that is shades of green, as you can clearly see in the picture. NVD is most often used by military and law enforcement agencies. Next slide, please. Okay, so these are the, you know, most famous rifles, and we have, you know, heard it many times. And those are AK-47, and next one is AK-56. If you see in the pictures, both are, you know, very similar looking. You know, you have to study about them to understand the difference about this. So we'll start with the AK-47. AK-47 is 4.3 kgs and AK-56 is 3.8 kgs. The AK-56 is much lighter than AK-47. And the origin of this one, AK-47, is from Russia. And AK-56 is the Chinese copy of AK-47. Country of origin is China. AK-47 is officially known as Avtomat Kalashnikova. Okay, he was the man, you know, he got the name from the man who, you know, designed it, who made it. AK-47 refers to the year it was finished. That was, it got the name AK-47. AK-47 was officially accepted by Soviet Armed Forces. AK-47 has a detachable knife bayonet. You can, you know, remove it whenever you want. Automat, the word initially meant automatic. Name of the designer is Mikhail Kalashnikov, you know, the man who designed it. We'll, you know about him in the next slide. The one magazine can hold up to 30 bullets, and both of them has a gas operated rotating bolt firing action, and both have a maximum efficiency range of about 400 meters. And the post fix 56 stands for the year it was manufactured. It is 1956. AK-56 assault rifle is a bit lighter, and AK-56 also holds a folding spike bayonet. You can fold it. Okay, so we can move to the next slide. Okay, so here is the man who, you know, made the most, you know, one of the famous AK-47 rifles and many other. He was a Russian lieutenant general, inventor, military engineer, writer, and a small arm designer. He is most famous for developing the AK-47 assault rifle and its improvement, the AKM, AK-47, as well as the PK machine gun, RPK light machine gun also. So he held a degree in Doctor of Technical Science. So at that time he was called the Doctor of Science. And during his career, he designed about 150 models of small weapons. So I'll just share some names of the weapons he had designed: AK-47, AKM, AK-74, AKS-74U, AK-74M, AKS-74, AK-101, AK-102, AK-103, AK-104, 105, and AK-12. RPK-74, PK, PKM, and PKP, and Cygnus semi-automatic rifle. Next slide. Okay, the Krumlov. It is a curved barrel, and you can see in the picture, the second picture on the right hand side, how it is curved, and it is a bent attachment to the Sturmgewehr 44 assault rifle developed by Germany in the World War II. Okay, that is attached to it, and it helps if in case there is an enemy and you cannot directly approach to it, they can use this one. It is a bent, so it has a camera which is in the bottom, then the white light, night vision, and the pistol, and it also has a screen which helps you to see. Okay, we'll move on to the next slide. Okay, these two are the pictures. Again, the left hand side is a type of model, the first one, and the second one also. Okay, so I hope you guys have learned something from the information I gave about the archery and about the rifle shooting. And can you just move on to the second last slide? Okay, so there is a message that I would like to share with you. That is, Bhavans Nature Adventure Center believes in harmless world, non-violence, and helping others. And the most important is, weapons are meant for defense, not offense. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Anup sir, for this amazing session about rifle and archery. So guys, if you have some questions, please do comment on the chat box. Anup sir, we do have some questions.
Okay.
So the very first question is, how is the cannon used?
Cannon used. Okay, so basically, if you have seen the oldest type of cannons, we have to load a big, how can I say, as a bullet or big round shell inside the cannon, the old one, which are the big ones, and you have to ignite it from the backside. And same as the hand cannons were.
Okay, is there any notes? We do have other questions.
Okay.
The next question is, why do we call it as a semi-auto, and if it's a semi-auto, is there any type which can call fully auto about rifles?
Okay, why it is called as semi-auto rifle, right? The first.
Yes.
Okay, semi-auto is that it has an option for that bolt action rifle or this one. So semi-automatic means half the few things that you have to do it for using the rifle. It is not fully automatic. Fully automatic is once you have load the magazine, you just have to aim it and pull the trigger. And semi-automatic, you have to do it somehow.
Okay, thank you sir. We do have some other questions. Difference between an assault rifle and a semi-automatic rifle.
Okay, the difference between assault rifle and a semi-automatic rifle.
Yes sir.
Okay. So semi-automatic rifles, firearms has a fixed magazine with a capacity about except 10 or something. And the assault rifle, it is an automatic firearm that has not been, it is an automatic. The simplest one is that it is automatic, and in the semi-automatic, you have to change it.
Okay, one more we have. Difference between machine gun and submachine.
Okay, so about this one, I'll just tell you one thing is that this has a lot detail, the difference in that. So if you want a proper answer for this one, I'll like whoever has asked the question to leave this question in the comment box, and I'll just revert back to you as soon as possible with a nice, you know, proper understanding answer for this one. Because it will not, you know, a proper if I don't give a proper information about this one. So I'll get back to you as soon as possible.
Okay, there's one more last question. What is the fire range of a muzzle loading rifle?
Yeah, even this one is about 70 to 80 this meters. 70 to, you can say 90 to 100 meters.
Okay, thank you, Anup sir, for this amazing session. Guys, if you still have any queries, you can email to our website, which is Bhavan's Nature Adventure Center. So you do have some questions, you can just email us. So we will see and reply you back as soon as possible. Thank you, Anup sir, for this amazing session. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Anup sir, for this amazing session. I hope everyone liked the session. Do sit and see more sessions of ours. You can log out now. Thank you so much.